Good morning, Victory Youth. Happy July 18th. Can you guys believe that school is starting back in a couple of weeks? I'm so sorry and so sad for you all, but I know that God is going to be faithful just like he was last year. The same way he carried you through, I believe he's going to do that and more this year. So we're excited. But today we're most excited about just praising God and worshiping him. He's been so good to us. He's been so faithful. So come on, guys, let's give God some worship this morning.
Mayday, mayday. The earth is shaking. Who gon' save the babies from another bloody Sunday? I'm singing mayday, mayday. They love me or they hate me for my skin color. But you say I am your brother.
The government keep lying to me, telling me that they come to set the people free. But the power falls when you catch us on the knees. Heaven, please, we're in a state of emergency. See, we need a strong God, yeah. We need the real God, yeah. The God with the resurrection power from the grave. Take away the hate, to heal the human race, yeah. We need a strong God. So
they made it, made it. They said the climate changing, the poor people in the cold. But you keep preaching to their soul. But we don't leave till everybody's free. And we won't sleep till everybody eats. Until lives matter.
All right, I'm so excited because we are doing our Wisen Up replay this summer. And this week might have been just my favorite. We had a special guest. If you remember, Pastor John blessed us last summer in the Wisen Up series. So let's take a look at what he has to say about wisdom.
What, you want my phone? Okay. Here you go. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. My phone? You want my phone? You know what? I'm sick and tired of every single time I turn around, you always got something to say. Like, get off me. You know what I'm saying? Like this is my phone. I don't go through your phone. I need some privacy. I wish sometimes you would just mind your business. Man, dang, always bothering somebody. What's up, CYM family? Listen, I want to just get right into this. Proverbs 15 and 3. This is what it says. It says, God doesn't miss a thing. He's alert to good and evil alike. Once again, God doesn't miss a thing. He's alert to good and evil alike. If I were to name this message, I would name it Private Page. Before you trip out or whatever, I wanted to show that skit that we did earlier, because if you're anything like me, on one portion of it, you have the thing that we actually say to our parents, yes ma'am, yes sir, okay, you can, you know, they take your phone, they take your whatever, they go through your stuff or whatever, go through your backpack to see what you've been doing. That's what we say, but on the inside, we say something totally different, right? Like, that's what I wanted to show, because after all, the reality of it is that what we actually are looking for is some privacy. And sometimes, if you're anything like me, when I was your age, not too long ago, actually a couple days ago, I was actually your age, I used to sometimes not want my parents in my business. So much so, you know, y'all know the story. I've told it many times. I wanted some privacy. So, you know, about 16, 17, while we was in church, I took my parents' car because I wanted my privacy. That's what it was about. Like, I didn't want to tell them that that's what I was doing. You know, but that ended up the way it ended up, right? So we all are in search for privacy, because privacy gives us some seclusion. It gives us some separation from, you know, the rest of the stuff, man, you know? So it's like, we all are looking for some sense of privacy, and privacy has its space, but this is the thing that the reason why I call it private page is because what I realized, even for me, you know, I only have one Instagram, but what I realized is that there's something out there, you know, called a private page. Some people call it a Finsta, like I've heard that too, but like literally, you know, there is a me that I understand that I have been placed in image-wise. I'm a pastor, I'm a this, I'm a that. So what I do is I create, that's the page for the general public, for everybody to see. But the reason why I would create a private page is because the private page now allows me now to be who I really am, like the five or six people without the judgment. That's just the way it goes, right? Like, you know, that's what we do, because it's private. But according to this scripture, it says God doesn't miss a thing. So he actually sees everything. So there is no such thing. What do we do when we try to have a private page in our lives where we try to hide stuff from God? And I'm here to tell you, number one, that there is no such thing as a private page with God. God doesn't separate who you are. Like you, this is the image of what we all portray to people, and then this is who we really are. God is not processing who we are that way. So it says clearly in the scripture, it says God doesn't miss a thing. He's alert to good and evil alike. So what's the first point? If you're taking down notes, this is your first point. God is always watching. God is always watching. This term alert, it actually is in reference to like a lighthouse, or like, I don't know if y'all even know what a lighthouse is. I'm hoping that you, here go a picture of a lighthouse right here if you're watching. So literally, the purpose of a lighthouse is not just something just to shine light on you for the purposes of exposure. But when a ship is in the ocean, there's rocks and all kinds of things that are out there. The purpose of the lighthouse now is to light up all the rocky spaces and places so that the ship can navigate around some of those things. So one of the reasons why God is watching is not just to point out the finger of what you're doing wrong, but there's some things you can't see. Because so God is more so like in a helicopter looking down at the whole entire picture, and you only got a fractional one. So there is no such thing as a private page, not for the purposes of just trying to make it to where your life ain't fun, but so that you understand that God has a full picture. He wants to protect you even sometimes from ourselves. That's number one. God's always watching. Number two, God is a participant. God is a participant. Real talk. You ever been in class? This happened to me one time. I remember I was in the fourth grade. I had a teacher named Miss Avro out in the elementary school, right? I was chilling. And I was a good kid, though. I wasn't really talking or nothing, but I had a homeboy that was always running his mouth. True story, this is what happened. Y'all don't do this no more, but when I was in fourth grade, they had these big old giant circles, and if you was in detention, you would have to go sit in that circle and watch everybody play in recess, right? So they sit you in a circle so you could watch everybody play. So I'm sitting there, I'm getting ready for recess or whatever, and my boy and my other homie is, they talking, but I'm next to them, and all I do is I just turn my body to listen to what they were saying. I just turn my body to listen, and when I turn my body to listen, my teacher said, "Hey, you three over there, you guys are all on detention for recess." And I was like, "On detention?" But I didn't even say nothing. Have you ever been in class and got accused of talking by your teacher and you didn't even do nothing because you were just near it? There's a term that we use like in the criminal justice system. They call it accessory, right? That means that you were close enough in the proximity of it that it could be you. Even if you didn't do nothing, you were an accessory to it. If you were in a car and somebody went into a store and they robbed the store and came back out, even though you didn't rob the store, you was in the car that the person who did rob the store, you were in the same exact car. That makes you an accessory. Can I tell you something? God is not just high up looking down on what we're doing. He's also in us. God lives in you. So because he lives in you, that means everything you do, there's no such thing as a private page. God now becomes an accessory to everything that you do. What are you trying to say, PJ? Whatever you're doing, whatever you're saying in your other life, with just your 10 or 15 people, that your parents may not see, that your uncle may not see, that your family may not see, you make God an accessory. Because he don't just live, he's not just up somewhere looking down on you, he lives in you, which means that everything you do, you make him a participant. He now becomes he becomes an accessory to your private life. Do you want God participating in everything that you do? I don't. Ease up. You good? Chill out, man. We just talking, right? Relax. We good? Last point. We getting out of here. My 10 minutes already up. Last point. God is not just looking for the bad. God is not just looking for the bad. God is not just looking for the bad. I don't like going to the doctor, but a doctor has his purpose, right? They have this thing called a checkup. The purpose of a checkup is to just check you out to see if your body is functioning at the highest level. So when you go to the doctor, if you notice, they're not just examining you to detect the bad. They will examine you to say, hey man, hey listen, your blood sugar is good, your blood pressure is good. It's also the scripture says it clearly. It says that God is alert not just to the bad, but he's alert to the good too. Some of y'all, you get mad because your parents is always pointing out, man, somebody's always saying something, somebody's always on me, somebody's always saying something, da, 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 da. You feel like the only time people talk to you is when it's bad. But what I'm telling you is that God has not just got a light on you for the bad stuff, he also got a light on you for the good stuff. I like that part about God. God is not just in search for the stuff that I'm doing wrong. He's also in search for the stuff that I'm doing right. He's also in search for the stuff that you're doing right. So just like you would go to get a checkup, this whole idea of God watching, with this wisdom that Proverbs has given us is basically showing us God is not this big bad wolf, but in that same token, there is no such thing as a private page. If I can tell you anything today that I would say that we should process together. Even when we were getting ready, prepping this earlier, somebody just said earlier, they said, hey, kids ain't the only ones that got private pages. We got private pages too. So even for your mom that's sitting next to you or your uncle sitting next to you, I ain't just preaching to you. I'm preaching to them too. The reality is that we all suffer from this idea of privacy or isolation. Because there's a word that we don't use much in church anymore. Sin makes us hide. Sin makes us want to have a privacy or isolation. And so if I were to tell you something in my clothes, I would want to, from my heart, tell you, is that I want you to process what it means to live a life in the light. What does it mean to live a life in the light? Because can I tell you something? There is no freedom in the dark. There's no freedom looking over your shoulder. There is no freedom having to go into your phone and delete stuff. Because you know one of us is going to come looking at your phone eventually. Ain't no freedom in that. There's no freedom in the dark. There's only freedom in the light. I wanna pray for you, and pray specifically if you're watching this. I wanna pray specifically for. I'm gonna say it this way: those of you who feel picked on, and tell you like I want you to do something different. I want you to reimagine what's happening as opposed to being picked on, but you actually are being loved. You feel like, you know, people always in your stuff or whatever. You're getting older, you wouldn't be treated like, you know, the age you are or whatever. Can I tell you something? I get all of that. But I want us to focus on the you when you're not around your parents, when you're not around adults, when you're just with your people. Who are you then, man? I want to pray about that. Like, can we talk about that? Let's pray together. Lord, I come to you for my bro, my sister, and I ask you to help us. Help us, God, in the spaces and places that we don't want people to see. What we've learned today, God, is that even though people don't see it, we've made you a participant in whatever we do. And so, God, I ask now that you would change our minds about where we are, change our minds about where we're going, and help us, God, to be the same person in every environment so we don't have to change who we are. Help us to be a real person, not fake, not having no fences, not one way in front of one person and then something different to somebody else. We ask that you give us a consistent identity. And Lord, we even pray this. If you're watching this, I want you to pray this prayer with me. Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus, I'm a sinner. I believe that you died and you rose again for my sins. God, I don't want to be a person that hides in the dark. I want to be connected to you. I want you to live inside of me. God, I want you to help me. In Jesus' name. If you prayed that prayer for the very first time, you just now made Jesus a participant in your entire life, which is not a bad thing. It's one of those things that makes us mindful. And just remember, he paid a price for us to live in the light so we don't have to be in the dark. This is your boy, PJ. I will hit you with something right now, but I'm sitting down, got the energy, but I'm feeling like I want to hit you with something, but I'm gonna just let it go. But I'm telling you right now, I'm coming back, and I'm not preaching the next time. I'm coming back, and I'm gonna hit you with this TikTok I've been working on, and yeah, it's hot. And if you're laughing, I don't know how much Jesus you got, because that's not a game. Look at my face. I ain't playing. I'm serious. For real. Peace.
Oh man, that was such a good word. I pray that you were blessed by it this week. I hope you hold on to what he said about sin and how much God loves us, and there's nothing that we can hide for him. There's nothing we can do that would separate us from God's love. So guys, make some good choices this summer. Continue to be wise, to be prudent, to be diligent and faithful to God and his word. We love you dearly. Have an amazing week. Oh, last thing. Next Sunday, we are having an in-person gathering just for you. The congregation will be doing family prayer, and we have a special prayer service for all of our youth, all of our middle schoolers and high schoolers in Henry Hall. You don't want to miss this. If you have been needing just a special time with God in worship and prayer, if you have some friends who have been needing that, we want you to come next Sunday, 6 p.m. See you there, guys.